고막과 청 어쩌고로 넓혀두긴 했는데 시끄럽기만 하고 도움이 안 되잖아. 도움이. 아, 다른 걸로 교체할까? 비용은 어떻게 하면 되겠지?
Hey, you figure that out on your own. Greetings and salutations, everyone. I'm Ekamak. This is Limbus. Let's play Limbus Company Murder on the Warp Express. In the last episode, well, presumably we're going to pick a fight with the Blood Fiend responsible for all this. We have some familiar faces and some unfamiliar faces. Effective affinities are question mark, question mark, huh? Yeah, let's go.
Dante, 이번에는 누굴 배워버리면 되는 거야?
This room... What is with that look on thy faces? Thou standest in the audience of the prince. Where are thy obsequious smiles? He must be the cause of this outbreak, the blood fiend we must defeat. Fall to thy knees and grovel before royalty. Who the hell are you to make those demands? I shall impart this upon thee only once, so listen well. You may call me Cassetti, sixth kindred, a kindred of the sixth generation, the rightful prince and refuge from his family. Art thou the villain? Who hath brought such destruction and massacre upon this vessel? Thou art a chatty one, so rudely before you, prince. Yet I am feeling generous, for I am quite sated at the moment. As thou must have seen on thy journey here, this place is a hall of banquet for a feast most majestic. No matter how many blood bags I create, no matter how much I devour them, the humans just won't stop coming. I only enjoy what was cast into my maw. He dons a mask for the purpose of merrymaking. If we're really going to exchange pleasantries, why don't you take that mask off? Do you not even know the basic etiquette? Oh, this mask won't come off. Can't take it off. Shouldn't take it off. There's no prince without the mask. We're so ugly behind the mask. So we all decided to hide how repulsive we've become. But once I've drunk your blood full, then it'll all go back to how it used to be. Only then can I unmask myself. Who stitched that mask to your face skin? Not a half bad job. Of course it's excellent. Because this mask was crafted by none other than the great, the eminent, the barber himself, whose name I dare not even speak. But it hurts so much. No, I'm smiling. Look how hard I'm smiling and laughing. Yes, I am the prince, that's what I am. He's a bloody loon, innit? All right, done with the giggles then. Get ready for the beating of your life. I enjoy things like you and your friends. Don't cry, bawling and bowing and sniveling on the ground for your lives. Lunge at me instead, hmm? The aggression, the boiling blood. Oh, how I love the fire. What are you, daft? Look round. There are 13 of us and only one of you. Do not let your guard down, Heathcliff. This entity has managed to turn countless passengers of this train into his blood bags. I ain't letting my guard down, but we blasted through so many blood bags we couldn't even keep count, didn't we? Couldn't even keep count? Oh, no. But the count is so important. I have to keep count of our visitors. Oh yes, of course, I do remember to keep count of our dearest visitors. Yes, sir, I do. You have no idea how powerful I am, and I shall not relinquish my throne to thee from this budding kingdom. All I have to do is sit here and do nothing, and the blood bags present themselves before me. There's no paradise like this out there. You have no idea what I did to create this place. Oh, how elated my forebear kindreds would be, should they be here to witness what I have created. This cornucopia of abundance, this pleasure, oh, this freedom. But this kingdom is mine! I've made it! I'm not giving it away! This is rather curious. It appears that this blood fiend leaves this car only on rare occasions. yet we have seen signs of his insidious influence throughout every car we have visited so far. Then what he means by how the blood bags present themselves before him has to be... Hold on a minute! Gah! A figure suddenly and frantically charged into this car. It was Sasha, the fixer we ran into on one of the earlier cars. Cassetti shrinks into his throne at the sudden burst, terror apparent in his face. Ah, it is thee, Bightly. Hast thou truly journeyed here to assist us in our quest? Lo, that villain is the blood fiend responsible for the tragedies that hath transpired aboard this train. Help us slay that cur, and eventually lead the passengers thou hast protected thus far out of this train. Blood fiends. What if there was more than a single blood fiend on board? One still capable of rational thought. Damn, he actually made it all the way back here. I guess the wings don't give out contracts to just anyone. I fought my damnedest too, till I was the last one standing. What's she talking about? In the end, I stood alone with nothing but a single one of these forearms left. Kinda funny how the perspective on life can just completely flip when you're really, really in the shit. I think my last thoughts were, man, I don't want to die. So I fell on my knees and pleaded. I told him that, Don Quixote, watch out! I'd do anything to live. Blood rapidly crystallized around Sasha like a suit of armor as she swung her greatsword at the sinners, striking them even before four sinners finished her sentence.
Ah! What? What did I say? I commanded you to give me a warning before jumping in like that. Don't you know how loud your stupid arms are? I thought the family had come for me.
I'm sorry, Lord Cassetti.
Allow me to introduce my kindred to thee, to be the first of many since my escape for the kingdom I intend to build. My kindred, my loyal squire, shall be at my side as I build a dynasty of my own. My family.
Lord Cassetti, I had intended to select the more powerful of the bunch to send to this car, as you have commanded me, but the humans in my car were all weaklings, so I present you before you this group from the first-class car.
Kindred. Are you even aware of the exact nature of a kindred?
Nah, but I can tell you this. When I accepted my lord's blood into my veins, it was though I was reborn.
I see. A kindred to a blood fiend is like a sub-entity, similar to sub-entities created by distortions or abnormalities. It must have been desperation that drove you to accept that proposition without hesitation, despite the lack of relevant information.
Maybe that's probably what was going through my head before I became a kindred.
Thou hast been in cohorts with this villain all this time as his underling? Even ere then, when we first laid our eyes upon thee?
Lady, you have no idea how much I freaked out when one of you asked me something about red eyes. Not it would have mattered if you did suspect me though, since my red eye is just prosthetic.
Then, the passengers who are under thy protection. Haven't I told you that the count matters? The longer the line, the better.
Dozens of blood bags began shambling into the room from behind Sasha. A smaller one among them stood out to me. My mind immediately snapped to the child who grabbed Don Quixote's coattails. I knew that the passengers were dead the moment we realized Sasha was a blood fiend, but this... I really, really hoped I wouldn't have to face this reality. Not like this.
There was a child.
Yep, little runt wanted to be a fixer if she got to grow up. Good thing she won't, though. I can tell you on good authority that living as a blood bag is way better than the drudgery that is the life of a fixer. Believe me, I'd know.
Hold thy vile tongue.
Dreaming of becoming a famous, respected fixer and an actor of justice is just a stupid pipe dream that always ends in crushing disappointment. Or a really, really early grave.
Silence! Silence!
Don Quixote did not give Sasha time to finish her sentence. She was already charging full speed at her with her lance drawn. two waves. These ones start out with a lot less health, though. And conditions unmet for one of the passives. So we just ignore you for fun. I can let you get off one hit. Man, the one downside to this setup is that we get absolutely no sloth resonance here. All of these are craving passengers though, so I guess we don't have to worry too much there. Okay, let's give Ishmael the killing blow on this one for the SP bonus. What else can we do? Okay, you're the most likely to fail the coin flips, so I'll throw in Warp Ryoshu here. The important thing to keep in mind is that this is not like Refraction Railway. We don't get a level advantage, so we do have to keep an eye on Ishmael's SP. Ooh, it struck me that it actually would be really nice to have Ryoshu's Envy, to have Ryoshu's Ego, because it is Envy, so she would be able to help out with an Envy resonance when we need it. Yeah, I'll just give Ryoshu a free hit off here. We don't have much in the way of gloom, so we actually don't get teleport. Oh, it's Sasha. Okay, if panic, reset SP to 0. Gain bleed count every time the unit is hit. Consume bleed count to gain coagulated blood. Prioritize targets with bleed. If they fail to deal any damage, gain fragile and offense level up. When hit, if the attacker uses a skill that gains charge, steal charge count from this unit. Self-inflicted damage cannot kill them. At less than charge gain attack power down at 5 plus charge gain clash power up, so we would actually want a full charge team for not this nonsense. Take less damage from targets with bleed, and on hit, if target has bleed, heal 25% of damage dealt, so you are an actual boss. We don't know what you're weak to though. So this is probably just a time to throw caution to the wind and go all in on Envy. Oh, I should have saved it. I should have saved his attack for this turn. Darn. Actually, no, we can finish you off. We won't get full party SP for it, but we can at least help out, because if someone else gets it, then Ishmael's SP goes down. Oh, I actually should have looked at what her SP effects are. Weird. Okay, your sanity passive. Bloodthirst. Low morale, gain fragile and damage up. At panic, gain more fragile and damage up. Decrease after losing a clash. Increase after this unit defeats an enemy, or increase if an ally defeats an enemy. Or increase if an ally defeats it. So basically she just doesn't care about her allies, I guess? Okay, yeah, it decreases after losing a clash, so that's why it went up. Do we just go all in on beating her into the ground? It's tempting. We know you're weak to all the physical elements at the moment, but that's because you're staggered. Weak to Envy, but that's because we only used Envy last turn.
풍전 기능 점검. 단순의 점검. 공간을 뭉갠다. 하! 맘. 이 작살에 필살의 집념이 담겨있지.
도망쳐봤자 헛수고다. 도전하는 하나님 어디에서든 네 머리통을 화려하게 터뜨릴 테니.
Unbelievable! My first Kindred to be created without their authorization! Is this bumbling fool? I pray for your forgiveness, my parent. Be gone from my sight. At least thou hast brought me blood bags for sustenance. Yet it must be the responsibility of a parent to clean up the mess of his child. What a load of shit. With that, Cassetti reaches out toward the pile of blood bags on the ground and... Yep. Looks an awful lot like Nosferatu from Library of Ruina now. Oh, what abundance! I'd nearly forgotten this sensation! An armor of hardened blood materialized over the Blood Fiend's body. His sheer aggression and hatred was palpable enough to make our skin crawl. It appears he has empowered himself by reaping their blood. Though my power is yet to fully return, this magnificent armor is quite befitting of a parade for the prince who hath become a king. Wouldst thou agree? Yes, sir. Yes, you do. Of course you do. Challenge me now, O rebels. Challenge thy king. Base power for every bleed on the target. If target has bleed, gain clash power, inflict bleed count. But hey, we have charge. That's nice. Now if only we had Donnie's blue skill, then we could have gone for a 6 Pride Resonance. Yeah, there's a slight problem with our version of Yisang, is that without any sloth he can't use any ego. Actually, passive insanity. So Bloodthirst, he gains the same thing as she did. Increase after winning a clash, decrease after losing a clash. At the end, depending on stored blood value on self, at 5 or less, gain 1 bind, 1 fragile, 1 offense level down. For every stored blood lost. At a value greater than 5, gain offense level up and defense level up for every excess value. Prioritize the target with the highest sum of bleed potency and count. On hit, if the target has bleed, heal 2% HP. When this unit has bleed, gain offense level and defense level up for every 5 bleed, up to a max of 10. Ouch. Gain clash power up for every 10 bleed, to a maximum of 5. Take 50% less damage from bleed. Lose 1 value every time this unit loses HP. He's gonna have some nasty stuff coming up, I just know it.
저놈을 추적해!
If the target has bleed, clash power plus one, deal extra damage for clash, bleed. Inflict 8 bleed and 2 bleed count, ouch. All of our really good ego we just don't have the resource generation for it. Definitely could have picked a better party for this, but their base skills worked really well together. It's just this nonsense that doesn't. Was there a 10 turn time limit on this one? Because I definitely am not going to get it. Unclashable. Double the amount healed by Hard Blood Glaive. Do not get staggered this turn. End turn after using this skill. Inflict bleed and bleed count. Bleed and bleed count, bleed and bleed count, bleed and bleed count. This is one where it would be really nice to use evade skills. Unfortunately, not everyone has them. Oh yeah, that's gonna hurt. After attack, gain stored blood. Gain a new pattern when stored blood reaches zero for the first time. Fix this unit speed to 10 when using the skill I am the Prince of the Parade. We're missing out on his gluttony evade, but I would rather not let him get this hit off. Really wishing I had known that I need these. I need to be able to evade these attacks. So he's very resistant to lust, unfortunately. If target has 8 plus bleed, coin power plus 1. Clash lose stored blood. Okay, yeah, we have to intercept this one because it rolls too high for anyone's normal attacks. Unfortunately, this means that we're losing our access to Contempt Ore. Fun thing is, because he hit the passive for Queequeg Heathcliff, gain offense level up and defense level up next turn every time an ally is attacked. Gain two of each if an ally is from the Quakod. He just hit the max on his offense defense level up, so he can actually beat this attack. Six plus Envy Absolute Resonance. She's going to use her main attack, but she's going to do it with 5 Envy damage up. 5 Envy damage up. And as part of an Envy Resonance chain, so it's actually going to help a lot. The downside is that I need to figure out a way to finagle this. Oh man, he even got all his SP back up. ...182 damage. Downside is he's now targeting everything onto Donny. Gain attack weight equal to number of targets with bleed. If target has 3 plus bleed, coin power plus 1, so... what attacks can we use to beat this? Provided Heathcliff wins, but if he doesn't, then we're in trouble. You better hit heads on this one, Donny. Oh right, he's also at negative SP because of losing clashes last turn, so we actually did have better odds there. Thing is, Lust Pair, so it's not going to be very good damage, but the upside is that it does give Donny a source of healing now, and we're going to need it. I'm never going back. Clash power for every bleed on the target. If target has 4 plus bleed, gain coin power. Double the amount healed by hard blood glaive. And gain 10 stored blood, because of course he does. Okay, there it is. So he's actually healing 4% instead of 2% should he get that off. Honestly, I feel confident there. We've gone over 10 turns though, so hopefully it's not a 10 turn run. Oh wait, no. Take that, and then... I guess it does make sense for this guy to be weak to Envy. Okay, I think we can finish it this turn. No fancy attacks, but oh well. Well, maybe a fancy attack, so we won't throw all our eggs into the basket. It hurts! Yes, I love your boiling human blood, but this is too painful. This guy keeps regenerating, no matter how many times we tear him to pieces. I don't know if we can. The mental fatigue finally got to Gregor and Sinclair, who collapsed to the ground. The strange environment of warp trains was proving to be a significant help to the Blood Fiend's regenerative ability. This fight's been dragging on even longer than our battles at the K-Core body border checkpoint, or the basement of Wuthering Heights. I knew the sinners had all grown stronger since then, but I felt as though I stood before an impenetrable wall. Don Quixote continues to wildly pummel the blood fiend with her lance, breaking, stabbing, and crushing him every time a body part regenerated.
I'm so hungry.
Ridiculous! Thy hunger is no justification for this massacre thou hast wrought.
Shut up! You don't understand! You don't know how awful it is to survive on that disgusting blood for 200. No, I don't even want to think about it. Shut up, be quiet. No, I'm sorry. Please let me just have a sip. Just the smallest sip, please. It's all useless. No matter how many times you stab me. I shan't stop until all of thy flesh and bone and organs are crushed into a viscous, shapeless mush. Never to become whole again!
But the blood fiend's regeneration is powerful. He's regenerating as fast as Don Quixote is destroying him. He's regenerating at an insane rate. We can't...
My kindred! My child! I have given thee new life, invited thee to this banquet. So do thy responsibilities! The blessing of a parent must be repaid, no?
What can I do?
Find their weakness, break their anchor. Make them kneel and grovel before me in desperation, just as you had.
Fate, I think I've got an idea. Sasha began looking around wildly, surprised by Cassetti's sudden command. It's that way they fight. Reminds me of the way we prosthetic using fixes fight. Just as prosthetic fixes slowly lose their sense of self-preservation. Their limbs become no more important than tools to be replaced. These idiots act with such abandon, as if they have multiple lives to burn through. With nothing to protect, they throw themselves wildly into battle like moths to a flame. And forget to look after what's really important, like this little thing. With one of her remaining arms, Sasha picked up the MasterCard key Faust showed her in one of the previous cards.
Don Quixote, stop her now!
Oh, my parent, I offer this gift to you.
Gah!
Don Quixote immediately leaped at the fixer, but one of her arms struck her away with great force. Ishmael and Mersault, who had been holding Cassetti down, were no match for his strength without Don Quixote's fury. The blood fiend threw them both to the side and grabbed the key card.
This is the key to the first class Cosma Lord. With this, grow your army of blood bags to bring glory to the kingdom.
No. Cassetti examines the master key card with clear interest. Without that key card, we'll be trapped inside this train for thousands of years until it reaches its destination.
Dante, I believed myself to be trying my utmost to overcome this adversity. Without access to Faust's knowledge and intelligence. However, with our loss of the master key card, the uncertainty of this circumstance is greatly exasperated. At the origin of this obstacle, Faust took a deep breath, as if she were about to take a deep dive into the source of all this trouble.
Must be my over-reliance on Faust. From what I can tell, Faust has always been operating based on information she received from the Faust. So in a situation like this, where she has to make decisions on her own, has to be unfamiliar to her. But Faust is an admirable sinner, with or without Faust. I've been thinking the same thing about myself, actually, that I might have been relying too much on that perfect Faust. But even without Faust, you still gave us good directions to follow after analyzing the information we brought you. Maybe uncertainty itself doesn't always have to be a problem for us. Remember? Thus the lack of plan itself becomes the plan. You said it yourself.
I see. Indeed, among many, I am a force that believes in uncertainty. Our loss of the master key card is but one of innumerable uncertain variables in the equation. The constant is, however, that the blood fiend is just as desperate as we are. Thus the only option that remains at present is to compromise. You there. Looks like thou art the one who's been regenerating your friends.
Stop doing that, alright? Don't heal a single one of them, or I'll smash your precious key to pieces. Manager Esquire? Compromise? To compromise with a villain as vile as that cur?
I didn't have the time to regenerate Don Quixote's severe injuries just yet, and the rest of the sinners were already unconscious. The only sinner who could still move or talk normally was Forced, whom I just rewound the clock for.
Yeah, let's do that.
Very well, then, Cassetti, why don't we move this conversation to a different location? Only I will accompany Dante to this negotiation. I will make my intentions clear now. Dante and I will not attack you there.
There is no doubt in my mind that Cassetti must be absolutely exhausted by the unending barrage of attacks from Don Quixote and the sinners.
Forced suggestion that we move this conversation to a different place without the sinners must have been a sweet one.
Just you two, huh?
Yes, the freight car is immediately adjacent to this one. That is where we will further discuss what we each have to offer one another.
That clock must be thy monarch then, and thou art one of the retainers.
Correct.
Very well, this will be a royal debate then. It is only right that a royalty talks to no one else but the one who is his equal. Manager, Esquire.
We'll be back in a minute, Don Quixote. Thus, we left the incapacitated sinners and Don Quixote, who watched with hollow, despondent eyes as we walked away. We carefully made our way into the freight car. So, Forced, why are we doing this in the freight car again?
Dante, this will be my first attempt at a gamble.
What? With that, the door closed shut behind us. Ooh, we'll find out what's going on here next time. Until then, guys, take care. I'll see you all around. Ooh, it was a close one though, wasn't it? And Yi Sang managed to get the flawless run, but he also dealt the least damage. I guess he is the only 2-star in that combo. Ah, clear within 15 turns. Okay, they were feeling quite generous there.